This right here is the cause of all of your internal torment and anguish. And when you and I are through with it today, it will know pain. It will know suffering at the hands of the Americans. I'm sorry, I couldn't help myself. When I was rehearsing what I wanted to start this little session of ours with in the shower this morning, what I wanted to say, as you may know, most of what I do is improv. I have a 90% of what I do is improv, stream of consciousness, just kind of run with it, you know, all that. I couldn't help but catch myself sounding like Brad Pitt from Quentin Tarantino's movie Inglourious Basterds. Have you seen it? Great movie. I would say Inglourious Basterds, Pulp Fiction, and Hateful Eight are my personal top three. You know, then there's Kill Bill 1 and 2, Reservoir Dogs, and the one about the slavery. I can't remember that one offhand. I'm not an idol worshiper of anyone, but I do admire, you know, the creative geniuses out there. Good now. I hope you're doing well, whoever and wherever you are across the world. Thank you very much, and no, I'm glad that you finally showed up here. Gonna be a lot of fun today for me and you. Not so much for this one. Hopefully you are feeling splentastic, if not better. But in the chance, you know, that you're just feeling not so good, you know, not all right, or just all right, just okay. That's all right, and that's okay. I mean, not really, but hopefully by the time we are through having our little fun today, you will be well on your way to feeling not bad. Oh, pretty good. Great, superb, excellent, wonderful, fantastic, splendid, splentastic, Feldrich nominal, spleentristic, or any of the infinite number of adverbs and adjectives that describe such a celestial state of complete and utter bliss, it's just incomprehensible to our simple ape brains. So, as you can see, right? Now, I know you have a couple questions. First thing is, you know, how was I able to get a hold of your depression? That, my friend, is a trade secret, okay? I cannot divulge how I was able to do that. If I was, then the secret would get out, and you know what people do. Once they find out how to do a thing, they ruin it, right? They learn how to profit it off of it. Capitalism, yay! But no, not everyone. Some people will be inspired and then take that inspiration and not copy, but create an homage to it in their own way. Create new art based on the inspiration instead of just a blatant copy, okay? A shameless, blatant copy because they can't think for themselves or whatever. They've never had an original thought in their head. But there's a lot of good artists, true artists, who will see a piece of art and then say, wow, that's so inspiring, like myself, when looking at anything that David Lynch has made or Salvador Dali or any comedian and be like, just it really resonates and you want to like do the same thing, but you want to do it in your own way and make something original kind of, right, anyway, so. All right, so that's the first thing, right? How I got a hold of it, I have my ways, all right? I was able to extract your depression from you when you weren't even aware. And then the second question is, you're probably wondering why your depression looks like this. That's just my conscious mind's way of manifesting your depression, okay? So everybody's depression looks different. All right, this is just what yours happens to look like. Mine looks a little different as well. Okay, so now, What we are going to do today is we're going to have some fun. We are going to give your depression a taste of its own medicine, okay? We know how shitty your depression can make you feel. Well, we are going to turn the tables and make it have not such a great day. And we are going to just make it feel awful. So that the next time it goes to think about doing what it does to you, it's going to, you know, think, oh, it... I that was horrible how Ephemeral Rift and its host, you, because you are the host, you're like a, you know, it's like a parasite. Now how they tied me down with electrical, with extension cord and it's not going anywhere, and how they just made me feel that day, and it's going to think twice about making you feel depressed again, okay? Now, I gotta say something. Depression never goes away. I'm 53 years old and I still have my moments. There are just certain people who, now, what I will say is, there's two things I wanna say. There are certain people who just, for whatever reason, we have a whatever chemical, genetics, chemical imbalance, however you wanna call it, that, makes us prone to be more down than upbeat and outgoing and happy. It's just the only thing I can think is it's a chemical thing and it's a genetic thing. Okay. The other thing is that it does get a little better with age. I no longer pop a Benadryl pill and sleep all day. And I've done that. I've like just called out sick from work or whatever. Pop the Benadryl pill because the antihistamine, those pills, they just always make me sleepy. And I would sleep from like the morning all the way through the day until night. And I would have some of those really lows. But I'm not emotional as I used to be. And so I feel that with the ebb, I'm more even keeled. I still have my moments. You know, but I'm not extremely happy or extremely depressed. I'm more right in the middle. Well, more balanced emotionally, and no longer just any of the extremes. And that kind of comes with age. So hopefully you will get there one day. But that doesn't mean depression goes away. It's just for me, my depression is kept, we could say, locked in the attic or locked in the cellar. And it once in a while, it comes pounding at the door, wants to be let out. Sometimes it does sneak out, but it's very rare. So, all right. All right, so what should we do today? How are we gonna make your depression feel as bad as it makes you feel? Well, I have just the thing. Depression hates this. I'm gonna give you a hug, okay? So, let me give you my friend a nice hug. There we go. All right, did you see that? It doesn't like that, makes it squirm. You might not be able to see it. I've gave it a numbing agent, a sedative. It's awake, okay? But it can hear and it can see. It's very present and conscious, but it's unable to move. But I still tied it down just in case the numbing agent was to wear off. Okay? All right, I'll give you another hug. There we go. All right. See that? It doesn't like that. Depression doesn't like that kind of stuff. And here, we can also, another great thing that your depression hates, rainbows. Happiness, a pleasant day, sun shining bright. See, it doesn't, it, you can see it, it, it really, you might not be able to see it, but it, inside it's just wriggling and it's all tormented, hates that. Friendship, So, speaking of happiness, I have here some official happiness particles. It looks like, it might look like confetti, right? But it's that's what actual happiness looks like in a manifested form, okay? But it's happiness particles, okay? Oh, it's gonna hate this. Watch this. Oh, look at all that, just all the happiness, ready? Some more happiness. How you like that, motherfucker? That's right. Just dump all this happiness right onto it. There we go, look at that. There we go. Oh, it's just burning. It's just burning all over. It can't stand it. Got a little bit of it in its eye. That's probably uncomfortable. Okay. All right, here's also what we can do. Spatula. Bad depression. You be nice to my friend, okay? You no longer make my friend feel bad, okay? Bad depression. Doesn't like that either. Okay, let's see, what else? Oh yeah, I have this little container. Gravel. I know this is not an ASMR video, and it's not meant to be necessarily. If you are a longtime subscriber, viewer, or maybe new here to my channel, I do primarily ASMR videos to create a more relaxed. But my channel initially started as some skits, not ASMR stuff. And I forgot about the fact that I can do stuff like this, and I enjoy doing these kinds of videos. So it's always going to be, you know, it's a mix. It's just from here until the day I can no longer do these videos, it's going to be a mix of nature, ASMR, and these kind of long-form sketch videos, whatever. Okay, anyway. So I don't know if this, I mean, maybe you'll still get ASMR. From this type of video, I don't know. So, but here's another thing we can do, right? How you like that, you prick, bastard, for making my friend feel bad. Don't you ever do that again. Just, you know how annoying that feels to have someone pebble you in the face? Well, not pebbles, but yeah. Now, like I said, I also have plastic hanger. Bad depression. Bad. Oh, I gotta put the happiness particles. The happiness particles are falling off. There we go. Okay. Burn, baby, burn. How you like that, huh? How you like that? Huh? You bitch. Your depression is a bitch. Okay. All right, so what else can we do? All right, I have, I was thinking about, you know, I have this and we could just, but I don't know. I think maybe that's a little too much. I have a baseball bat, right? We can give your depression a few whacks, right? Oh, look at that, that was good. Now, all right, we'll leave that like that. I like that, huh? There we go, that's good. A couple whacks of the baseball bat. Ice pick, right? We can just kind of, right? There we go. Give it right there, right in the heart. There we go. Your depression. Right like that. There we go, huh? How do you like that now? How does it feel? Huh? Happiness. The happiness particles are, there we go. Burn, baby, burn. Let's see. I have a hammer, right? We can just write on this. Ooh. Now imagine right there on the tender, just like that. Huh? How do you like that? That's what you get for giving my friend, your host, not feeling very good. Making down the dumps and all that. It's all your fault. You are a terrible thing. Depression. Do you know that? You really are. So, hammer, right? We can just. There we go. Okay. I also have a. A drill, obviously. So I thought what we would do is drill. Let's see, what drill bit should we go with? How about 532? How about we drill a hole into your depression's head? I know this is not very humane to do to your depression. I'm sure the Depression Alliance of America will probably send me a letter and say this is not how you treat your depression, but I concur. I think your depression deserves this. So we're just gonna go right here. Oh, it didn't want to. It was working for a minute. It doesn't, okay, we're having a hard time here. Okay, it doesn't want to. All right. It's got a really thick skull, but we can just. Right in the eye. How about right in the eye, huh? There you go. How do you like that, huh? This is what you get. This is what you get. This is what you deserve for making my friend feel like shit. Okay? Stop. For a long time. Like I said, can't make depression go away. Right? It's always going to come back and rear its ugly head. It's always just, it's going to take some time. But any time that you feel your depression coming on again, you should come pay me a visit and I'll be here. You just come here and I'll always be here ready to, to do what we need to do to your depression. Okay? And let's see. I have this here. I have this PVC pipe cutter. Here's PVC pipe. Before I bought, some of my videos, I have a black backdrop, or there's another backdrop I use for some of the Arkham Sanitarium videos. And that other backdrop, I have an actual frame. It's a black kind of, a black horizontal pole connects to other black vertical poles, and they have like a little tripod stand at the bottom of each of the vertical poles. So it forms a nice little frame, and you can hang a backdrop. But before I bought that, I figured, I gotta do it myself. Why spend the money when you can DIY, do it yourself, right? So I bought PVC pipe, and I bought little PVC couplings. You can see here, pipe fittings. So this would actually stand up like this. You can see here, there would be PVC pipe coming out here and here. So I would stand this up, so it would be like one end of the frame, and then I would have the coupling at the end going. But then it got a little wobbly and a pain in the ass. That's when I decided to buy my own, frame. This is what PVC pipe does. It's been a while since I used this. It looks like it's supposed to open up wider than that. It's not opening up that wide, but this cuts, is very sharp, so you gotta be careful. It was easier. Why is it not? It feels like it needs to go a little. It's not going wide enough. This is why as it goes. It feels like it needs to go wider or something. Did I break it or something? I don't know what's going on. But this is supposed to cut through the PVC. It's supposed to be fairly easy, but for some reason, I don't know. It's not that sharp or something. I don't know. Anyway, it's been years. It's been like probably 10 years since I've used this, honestly. So I thought what we could do is, cut off one of your depression's monstrous fingernails. I think maybe might be inhumane to cut off the fingers, but look at these fingernails, They really need to be trimmed. You need to take care of yourself. Maybe that's the problem with your depression, is it's depressed itself. I never thought about that. Maybe it's projecting its depression onto you, making you feel depressed. Is that the problem here? Do I need to play a couch psychiatrist and do a little analysis here? Is that your problem? Are you depressed? Look at that, it is. I feel bad now. Wait a minute. Hold on a second here. We'll clip its nails in a second. Is this the mask? Who are you, depression? Who are you really? Oh my God. Barry? Is that you? Barry, what are you doing? Barry, is your depression? I can't believe it. Is it true, Barry? Barry, why are you my friend's depression? No, I'm so sorry. Look at that. And I tried to drill a hole in your head and everything. Now I feel bad. Actually, you know what? You're not really Barry, are you? No, you're not. See, it's not. It's not Barry. It's my subconscious mind turned your depression into this. Yeah. So your depression is actually wearing a mask to hide itself, because actually it's depressed itself. I think something like that. Okay. Anyway. So, but you know what? Let's put the mask on. We'll put the mask back on because, yeah, there we go. Because I feel less guilty. Okay, so let's trim off. Look at these nails, huh? How do you like this, huh? Ha ha ha! How do you like that, motherfucker? Trim off those nails, and now you're not gonna be able to claw and scratch at my friend anymore, huh? Look at that. Oh, look at those long, pretty nails. Not anymore. Snip. This is what must feels like to be a cat. There we go. Last one. Didn't really quite work. Something's wrong with these. There we go. And of course, a femur. I'm not sure. I don't think this is a human femur. It's probably a cow femur or something. I don't really know. Anyway, bad depression. Bad depression. So, and let's just put some more of that happiness back on. All right, so let's just put more of that happiness. There we go, all over its skin. There we go, all over its hands. Really make it burn, and we're just gonna leave your depression here. I'm gonna keep your depression here, tied up. I think that's enough. I think we've taught it a lesson. I think the next time your depression goes to make you feel depressed, it's gonna think twice. I mean, if I was your depression, I would definitely, not want to make you feel depressed again, because I wouldn't want to go through this. So the next time you feel depressed, all right, you come here and I will do the same exact thing, all right, and help you, hopefully make you feel better, okay? And that's gonna it. So we're just gonna let it sit here. Just twist this around a little bit. There we go. I can't really, there's nothing much else. I do have a knife. And I can maybe just hang right there. There we go. All right, that's perfect. All right. I don't know. There in the hand, I think that's good. So we'll just kind of, yeah, there we go. All right. So we're going to go, I'm going to leave your depression here in my garage. And then at some point, it's going to just kind of dissipate and it'll go away. It won't be here when I come back. And it'll return to its host, to you, into your psyche, deep, unconscious, subconscious mind. And we'll just have to, you know, deal with it when it rises back up and all again, okay? So, I hope you're feeling better, okay? I'm just doing what I can, you know? But I think we gave your depression a dose of its own medicine. And, I think it's going to think twice about making you feel depressed again. All right? So, it was great to have you. Great to see you. I'm glad you could make it here. I wish you all my best. I hope you feel better. And that's going to do it. We'll just leave it sit here, let it just kind of burn in happiness particles, and just really make it, you know, just leave it alone here in the garage as it just kind of, you know, is tormented. All right? And that's going to do it. So, I wish you all my best, and I hope to see you again real soon, hopefully another video. And until next time, you take care of yourself, stay well, stay safe, and take care, and so long. For now. So how do you like that, huh? That's what you get. All right, so we're gonna leave you alone now. What do you say you and I go have some fun? Come on, let's go. Let's leave your depression here. Let's go.